गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एलिमेंट्स कंपाउंड एंड मिक्सचर। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल टॉक अबाउट प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ वाटर। एंड बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ वाटर, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेपरेशन ऑफ कंपोनेंट फ्रॉम द मिक्सचर। ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, सपोज अ मिक्सचर कंटेनिंग मोर देन टू कंपोनेंट्स, देन वॉट वी विल डू, we can follow more than two process. So here examples are given. First I have given you the mixture of sand, iron filling and salt. So how can you separate the iron filling? So here you can see, first process is that magnetic separations, and with the help of magnet you can separate iron filling from the mixture of sand and salt, because sand and salt are not the magnetic substances and iron filling is a magnetic substance. It will get attracted with the help of magnet. So by this process you can separate iron filling. So first process is that magnetic separation. Then after that, what will you do? We will do that filtration process. In this process, we know that salt is a water soluble while sand is not. This means the two can be mixed in water and stir. The salt will dissolve and sand will not. By the filtration process, we can separate sand. Yes, my dear student, with the help of filtration process, we can separate it. Already we have discussed in the previous lecture filtration process, and you can see that with the help of filter paper, we can separate sand, because sand is insoluble substances. It will be left out on filter paper, and we know the particles which left behind on the filter paper, that is called residue. Means in the form of residue, we will be able to separate out sand from the mixture of sand, salt and water, and you will get the clear solution, that is called filtrate. Already we have discussed what is filtrate. We get the filtrate and it contains salt. So this is the second process. By the filtration process, we can separate sand from the mixture of salt and water. And last process is that we can boil or evaporate the water, and salt will be left behind as a solid. Yes, my dear student, it is a third process. We can separate sand from water with the help of evaporation process. So it is very clear, when mixture contain more than two components, so we can use more than two process. And in this mixture we have done already three process. First one is that magnetic process, second one is that filtration, and third one is that evaporation. And with the help of these process, we can get every substances particularly. Now next one is that it is a very important topic, purification of water. Before starting the talking about purification of water, we must know what is contaminated water and what is potable water. The contaminated water means polluted water, means the water which is not fit for drinking, as it contained with poisonous substances or harmful microorganism. Yes, my dear student, the water which contain lots of poisonous things, germs, which cannot be used for drinking, that is called contaminated water. And its opposite, the potable water, which can be used as a drinking water, that is called potable water. Means it is safe for drinking. And you can see in image, a person, he is using water for drinking, it is a potable water. So we can use only potable water for the drinking, we cannot use contaminated water. Next, It is a very important topic, purification of water. So there are several methods used to water purification process, which includes, yes my dear student, I think in a big cities, Mumbai, Delhi, they do not have their particular, their personal hand pump and the water pumping system in their house. They have to take water from the government supply pipe. They do not have their private equipment. So they all family depends on the government supply water, and that water is obtained from rainwater, from the pond, from the sea, and this water must be purified before sending to the house. But we are very thankful to God, in Bihar especially, we are getting our own water. We have lots of equipment like a pumping system, hand pump in our houses. We can get water directly from the ground. That is a fresh water. But in the big cities, they cannot do that. They depends on what government supply water system. And that water must be purified before sending the houses. So these process are there before sending the water to the our houses. First one is that physical process. It includes filtration, sedimentation, distillation. Biological process, sand filter, active carbon. And then chemical process such as chlorination, ultraviolet radiation means ozonation. These are processes which are used to purify the water, to kill the germs, to remove the dirt from the water. So let's get started. We'll talk about every process. You can see here, it is a water treatment system. And it is your very important topic. I will ask in your examination. Suppose I will ask, explain the how water is purified. So you must draw the figure. It is given in a book also. And here you can see the images are given. So you must draw. So first process is that sedimentation. Already we have discussed sedimentation. Sedimentation is a process of separating small particles and sediment in water. This process happens naturally when water is still, because gravity will pull the heavier sediment down to the layer, and that is called sludge. Here, just underline it, sludge. We know that sedimentation means settling down the heavier particle at the bottom, and that settled particle means all impurities which get settled down at the bottom of the container, that is called sludge. So I will ask, what do you mean by sludge? So sedimentation can be used to remove heavy particles, dirt particles from the water. And also we can use one more thing to increase the rate of sedimentation. Already we have discussed alum. So loading. What is a loading? In a loading tank, coagulant like lime and alum. What the work of lime and alum? They make the dirt particle heavier, which help them to settle down at the bottom of container. Add to the water, which because suspended particles to clump together, means they combine with each other, small particles, they all clump together and make the heavy particles that allow the sedimentation of the suspended particles. Yes, my dear student, means the settling down. Loading means the clumping, yani coagulation of the minute particles together, and they will get settled down at the bottom. And also we know the alum and lime can increase the rate of sedimentation by the loading process. Already we have discussed these two processes: loading, sedimentation, decantation. Now next process is that filtration. The second step in water treatment system is a filtration, which remove particulate matter from water by forcing the water to pass through the porous media. It is given porous media means a layer which have very minute pores are there. like the bed of sand, gravels. The filter system consists of filter which varying size of pores and is often made up of sand, gravels and charcoal. I think many of you have seen Purit filter system. It is available in market, you can see. And in a Purit system, there is a one black charcoal system is there. That charcoal allow to water to pass through it because that charcoal have very minute pores. So sand, bed of sand and gravels is used to filter the water. In this system we cannot use big filter paper. We can use the bed of sand and gravels which act as a filter paper which filter the all impurities from the water. Here you can see that filter system, how it is used and how water is allowed to pass through the layer of sand and gravels which help to remove out all the impurities from the water. Next, destruction of harmful germs. After the removing dirt, after the filtering the water, third one is that we must kill the germs because that can lead to diarrhea, cholera, so many waterborne diseases. So first process is that aeration. What is aeration? Aeration is a process to bring water and air into close contact, means oxygen is supplied through the water in order to remove dissolved gases, which help in to remove dissolved gases such as carbon dioxide and to oxidize dissolved metal such as iron. Means aeration is a process which help in removing many gases as well as metal also, because they get oxidized. And what is oxidized, you will know about it in higher classes. Also oxygen, when we supply through the aeration tank, it also increase the rate of germs. And whatever germs they are there, na, they digest all the organic substances, organic impurities like sputum and all that. They oxidize the all organic impurities, and oxygen is oxidizes organic matter. Organic matter means the shit of, you can say, the dog, animals, sputum, all that. They will oxidize, means they will digest, because oxygen help to get it oxidized. Next is that chlorination, and after the aeration, it is a second last process. Chlorination, you can say the last process is also. Chlorination means water chlorination is a process of adding chlorine or chlorine compound such as sodium hypochloride. Yes, my dear student, sodium hypochloride. Now this chemical is used to spray in our locality to kill the coronavirus. Sodium hypochloride, and this is also used in water treatment system to water. This method is used to kill bacteria, virus and other microbes in the water. In particular, chlorination is used to prevent spread of waterborne disease such as cholera, diarrhea, typhoid. These are the waterborne disease. Just learn that. What is a waterborne disease, I can ask. So my dear student, chlorination is a process to kill the germs. In this process, chlorine and chlorine compound is allowed to pass through the water treatment system, and this is the last process before sending the water to our houses. But now modern system is that, I think in your all of you have a filter system in your house, RO. RO means reverse osmosis. And in this system, there is a ozonation process is there. Ozonation means what? Ultraviolet radiation and ozonation, or combination of both, are modern method to kill germs. Means ozonation is used in the place of chlorine in a good and high quality purified system ozonation is used. In ozonation, ozone gas is used to use in place of chlorine to kill the germs. Means like a chlorine, ozone is also working there. Means ultraviolet radiation, which is used to kill the germs which are present in the water. So I think you have seen in advertisement in TV, in my pure system have a ultraviolet radiation, means which help to kill the germs. This is a model method, but it is not a practical. It can use in a big commercial area, like it cannot be used in a big cities to clean the water. So in the big cities, we generally use what is that? Chlorination process. And modern method of chlorination is that ozonation. So ozonation is used in a high quality filter system, especially in our houses. So these are the process, my dear student, we can use to kill the germs. So it is very important. I may ask, what is the method to remove the impurity from the water in a water purification system? So all this system, all the process, just you have to write. You have not to explain what is this process. Simply, you can draw the image and you can write the name of process. In next lecture, we will start new chapter, means chapter number 3. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day, my dear student.